that you must
do. No prizes for the quality of the questions, but Hinkson keeps his dignity. He's out of the competition, though. So too is Siggy Wendt. So the West German challenge is completely gone. The British challenge goes on. There's Daly. All set for the next event, the long jump, and we'll join Ron Pickering.
Yes, there's a special sadness about Jürgen Hinkson going out in that way, because even in the German press, where the decathlon is their number one event and it fills the stadia there, Jürgen Hinkson has always been their bridesmaid. They idolised Daly Thompson in West Germany. And with Siggy Wendt sent home under a cloud and not passing their fitness test, and Guido Kretschmer, they're the big three, Hinkson, Wendt and Kretschmer, they're the big three that have challenged Daly over the past decade. Kretschmer's also injured, working here for television, ARD. Wendt is out and gone home, now Hinkson's gone, and West Germany have no athlete in the decathlon, and I can't remember how long that it is since that's happened. So Jürgen Hinkson sadly out, and now comes a long jump, which is a crucial one, because this is an event in which Torsten Voss is very good. He's done over 8 meters, and it's the make or break event for Daly Thompson, because in breaking a world record once in Gürzis, that lovely village that's just on the border of Austria, Germany and Switzerland, where thousands turn up, it's the home of decathlon, he injured his back very badly in a long jump, and the memories of that have meant that ever since the long jump has been difficult for him really to apply his talents to. At his best, of course, Daly Thompson is the best long jumper that's ever been seen, and he's actually done 8 meters 11. But it's some time, it's some years since he's jumped well, and in the last 2 years, by his own standards, he's jumped badly, and I mean really badly, and that's a big worry for him. And when we get to the long jump and we get over that, well, we'll be easing our way. He actually jumped 7:52 in Rome to score 940 points, but that's where Voss went ahead, and so we can expect a bit of leeway, but anything around 750 or 60 will be okay.
...1097, David Johnson. Christian Schenk of the German Democratic Republic has had a no jump in the first round in a decathlon. 3 jumps rather than the 6 in a normal long jump competition. And just to update you overall, Daly Thompson is leading with 947 points. Christian Plazier is second with 899. And Torsten Voss, the world champion, is third with a total... Well, at this stage, it really isn't that significant, having announced it, because, as Ron was saying, this event is the one that sorts them out.
A little note. I don't know whether it's worth throwing it in, but the only man who did better than Rome out of all the world's leading decathletes here in the 100 metres was Daly Thompson. Now that's the sort of thump on the board that Daly's going to worry about, because it sends shockwaves up through his spine, where there is a little bit of a weakness there. He's so heavily built and he's got such a slim waist that it, you know, all problems seem to go from that centre point. Now listen to this thump. If it's going to come, yes it does, but it's a no jump. He's marked the plasticine. There's 2 more jumps. This is again where discipline is demanded of the decathlete. Put your points together, all of them have to be within the rules, but you can see the energy he could have saved himself if he got a steady jump in there. That would leave him 2 more jumps in which he could ease out a bit and try and scrape a few more points. Now he's already put himself under a little bit of pressure. He's only got 2 more jumps in which to make any mark at all.